Hello my dear students, I am here to explain the new topic, the next topic, past tense. Okay, in my previous video I have already explained about the present tense, and first I told you about what are tenses. Okay, so the tenses are time of action of time. Okay, so this is the second type of tenses, past tense, in which the events has been passed away, that happened in past. Okay, so we will describe about, we will learn about the past tense today. And past tense also divided into three parts. Divided into four parts, not three, four parts. Indefinite, perfect, continuous, and perfect continuous. Okay, so these are also four type of past tense. These are as same as the present tense also. Okay, so we will learn about them one by one. First I will tell you the structure of past indefinite. Subject plus verb second form plus object. Okay, subject plus verb second form plus object. And in negative and interrogative sentence you will use did. So what is the example? He wrote a letter. This is the second form. Okay, he wrote a letter. If you will make this sentence in negative, how you will do? He did not write a letter. Okay, and in interrogative, did will come in the beginning of the sentence. How? Did he not write a letter? Are you looking here? With did you will write, you will write only the first form of the verb. Okay, if and without did you will write the second form, because did is the second form of do and does. So that's why with only once in one sentence there is only one second form. So this is that. Okay, and in second type of interrogative, in which WH words use, how you will make them? In the beginning of the sentence you will write WH words. Who wrote a letter? Okay, so who always works in a sentence as a subject. So with it you will use only verb second form. Okay, but if I will write the other type, other WH word in place of who, so how I will do? Why did he not write a letter? These are interrogative. So these are the forms of examples. This is affirmative, in which you are using subject plus verb second form plus object. And this is negative sentence, in which you are using did plus not plus verb's first form. Okay, and in interrogative first type, did will come in the beginning of the sentence, and then after subject and not, and verbs first form and object. And in second type of interrogative, WH word will be in the beginning of the sentence, then after helping verb, then after subject and not, plus verb first form and object. Okay, so these are past indefinites. So then after, let us learn about past perfect. In past perfect, perfect means complete, the work that has been completed perfectly. Okay, so this is called perfect. And past perfect, the work has been had been completed in past perfectly. So that is called past perfect, in which you will use subject plus had plus verb's third form plus object. Okay, and the other sentence, other type of sentence, you know, first I want to tell you, sometimes these sentences have two parts. Okay, jaise, just like mere ghar jaane se pehle wo so chuka tha. So there are two sentences. Mere ghar pahunchne se pehle wo so chuka tha. So the last sentences, the last sentence will come first, and the first sentence will go last. Okay, so that's why I will make you understand this sentence in two parts. I will write after, before, and second second sentence subject plus verb second form plus object. Okay, like he had slept. मेरे घर पहुंचने से पहले, पहले means before. I second form reached home. He had slept before I reached home. So there are two sentences. मेरे घर पहुंचने से पहले वह सो चुका था. वह सो चुका था पहले मेरे घर पहुंचने से. Okay, the last sentence will be come first, will come first, and the first will be last. Okay, and in a negative sentence only we will write here not. He had not slept. In the first sentence we will write not. Okay, and in interrogative sentence, how we will make? Had, he not slept before I reached home. Had will come in the beginning of the sentence, and then subject and not if there. Okay, and verb's third form, and after, before, by, tak aata hai, just like wahan wah kal tak aa chuka tha, kal tak. So what you will write here? By yesterday. Okay, kal tak, by yesterday. So here we will use different type of words: after, before, when, by. So before I reached home, this is the sentence. मेरे घर, क्या मेरे घर पहुंचने से पहले वह सो चुका था. So here the first sentence will be in interrogative. Had he not slept, वह नहीं सो चुका था. Had he not slept before I reached home. Clear? And in second type of interrogative, you will write only WH word in the beginning of the sentence. Why? I am using why here. Whilst WH were, why had he not slept before I reached home? मेरे घर पहुंचने से पहले वो क्यों नहीं सो चुका था? Okay? Is that clear? Clear, students? Any problem is there? Okay, right? And then we will learn about the continuous past continuous tense in which tha, thi, the will come in the end of the sentence and we will make this sentence like that. He was writing. First I will tell you about the structure. The structure is subject plus was plus were plus verb plus ing and plus object. So this is the structure of past continuous tense. How we will make it? Let us learn about learn this with the help of some examples. Like he was writing, write is the first form and ing, writing a letter. Okay, so you know with the singular subject you will use was and with plural subject you will use were. Clear? And in negative, he was not writing a letter. Okay, not will come between was and verb's first form. Okay, verb's plus ing form. And first type of interrogative, how you will make? Were they not playing? Were they not playing? Okay, with they is a plural subject, so we will use were they not playing. Okay, and in the second type of interrogative you will use only WH word in the beginning of the sentence. When were they playing? When were they playing? So when is a WH word, it comes in the beginning of the sentence and then after we will use helping verb and then subject and verb plus ing and then object if there. Okay, is that clear? Is clear everything? Okay, let us go to the next, perfect continuous. It's past perfect continuous. Okay, the structure of past perfect continuous is subject plus had plus been plus verb plus ing plus object. Okay, plus since for, since or for, and then trying. And in present tense I told you about the use of since and for. Since always use with certain time and for always use with uncertain time. Certain time is that in which time's name is not given. Okay, and uncertain time in which certain time in which time's name is given and uncertain time in which time's name is not given. Like Monday is the name of day, Tuesday, Wednesday, and what is the name of hours? 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock. So these are the names. if name were given, name are also there, names of time are also there, then you will use since, and without name you will use for. Okay, let us learn it with the help of example. He had been writing a letter since 2 hours, since 2 o'clock. 2 o'clock is certain time. Okay, clear? Subject plus had plus been plus verb plus ing. You know, perfect continuous is the time that started perfectly but continuously going on. Till now it is going on. Okay, so in past, what is the means of that perfect continuous? That beginning in the past but continuously going on from that time. Okay, and in negative you will use subject he plus had, sorry, he had not been writing a letter for 2 days. 2 days is uncertain time. Okay, because this is not the name of days. The name of days is Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. If there will be Sunday, Monday, and then what you will write? Since. Okay, and in interrogative, had will come in the beginning of the sentence. Had he not been writing a letter for 2 hours. Okay, 2 hours is also uncertain time, so that's why we are using here for. That clear? Okay, and in second type of interrogative we will use WH word, that already in Hindi sentence, in your that already will be in Hindi sentence. So I am writing you when. Okay, when had he not been writing a letter for 2 hours, then question mark will be there. Okay, that clear? So these are past tense, and I told you about the structures of past tense with the help of examples. In past tense, in past indefinite, you will use subject plus verb second form plus object. Okay, and in perfect tense, past perfect tense, the past perfect means that that the work had been completed. Okay, in past perfectly, so that's why you will use subject plus had plus verb third form plus object and plus after before, because these sentences are divided into two parts sometimes, not always. Sometimes this sentence have two parts, so that's why the last sentence always comes first and the first sentence always always in last. Okay, so the first sentence is in past perfect and the second sentence is in past indefinite. Okay, because it is not possible to write the both sentence, to make both sentence in the same structure in past perfect. So that's why one sentence will be in past indefinite. Okay, subject had plus verb third form plus object after before and then subject and verb second form and then object. Okay, And what was the structure of past continuous? As I told you, subject plus was verb plus verb plus ing plus subject. Okay, was will always come with singular subject and verb with plural subject. And this is the structure of past perfect continuous. In the subject plus had plus been plus verb plus ing and plus subject. And since for, since always come with a certain time and for with uncertain time, and then the time. You know, past continuous, perfect continuous means the verb that had started perfectly but is still going on continuously from that time. Clear? So these are your past tense. So you have to practice from your book and try to understand, try to know the structure of this sentence by making practice, because practice makes a man perfect. Okay, thank you.